this is John Colo with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you, and this is an episode I know many of you guys have been waiting for, because I get emails all the time, especially in the wrong season when it's like the middle of summer or the spring. John, you still selling your sunchokes? Well, you know, I only harvest sunchokes once a year, and actually last year I missed the harvest, so they basically stayed under the ground and I dug some up to eat, but most of them kind of just hung out and grew even bigger this year. So this year, I'm going to be offering my sunchokes to you, so stay tuned to the end of this episode. If you don't want to watch this episode, just check for the link down below to purchase my very sunchokes. I do have a limited quantity to offer this year. Anyways, what I'll be doing in this episode is sharing with you guys one of my favorite crops I believe you guys should grow for a staple food, right, that could produce a lot of calories in a little bit of space, and also a food that really you don't have to do much to. It'll just grow year after year, and it's basically native to all of North America. I mean, from California to Nevada, I've seen them grow in Arizona to like Maine, New York, basically anywhere in the continental U.S., this amazing plant will grow. And it's going to provide you guys food and lots of it, and also some beautiful flowers in the season. And so at the end of the season, at the end of your summer season, whenever that may be, the plant will tell you when it's ready to be harvested. So I don't know if you guys could see that, but behind me, it's right there. It's actually towering up in my garden. It's probably like over 10 feet tall, maybe 12 feet tall this season for this plant. Let's go over to it. And this is my Jerusalem artichokes all the way up here, super big, super tall. Pretty much it'll grow through the season depending on where you live. You might have to harvest it in September, October, or November, even maybe later. This one, you could tell kind of when it's getting old and straggly, when the leaves start to kind of get a little bit funky. They kind of get damaged by the cold. I mean, the plant knows that the weather's changing. It grew all throughout the summer, no problem. But it knows it's getting cold and it's coming to its life's end. So it's working on shoving down nutrients into the root zone to make those tubers bigger so that it can actually come back next year. And I do want to let you guys know that this plant can be invasive, and if you plant it once, it'll just start spreading out and sending its little tubers under the ground, and they'll start coming up. So you might want to either, you know, dedicate one raised bed to this, dedicate an area of your yard to this, or if you don't have a lot of space, even if you plant this in like a nice size half a wine barrel, you could grow lots of food, and even in a half a wine barrel. I think one year I grew these guys in like a 5-gallon pot, and it produced like, I forget how many pounds, but I'll put a link down below to that video if I remember. Anyways, we're getting to the end of the season here. The frost is coming up within the next 30 days, so we're going to take this guy down. So basically, I just like to chop it down. And let's see here. So it had some flowers earlier. I don't think there are any flowers on, but you can see the leaves are kind of getting jacked up. But basically, we just cut this down into pieces. And this is all going to go in my compost. And I'm going to go ahead and cut it down some more, and then we're just going to come back at you when I got basically the stalks coming out of the ground, and then we're going to pull up the roots. So now I got those trimmed back, and generally what I like to do when I harvest my sunchokes at the end of the year, when the top growth basically is at the end, I basically cut it off and I leave these sticks sticking out of the ground, right? Basically, these are placeholders for me. Normally, I do not harvest these guys unless I want to eat them, right? So what I would do is I just leave them like this all winter long, and this would let me know that, hey, if I need to harvest some sunchokes, I'll come out here and pull them up. Since I'm actually harvesting them to ship them out to you guys, we're going to actually pull them up right now, so I'll show you guys the process. So once you guys got these sticks, I really like it because I just come around and like rotate this around a little bit, you know, in circular motion, loosen them up, and then I'll just gently pull up. And when you pull up, check this out, man, this is really cool. Whoa, it broke. But you'll see, like, all these on the roots are all these little sunchoke things kind of hanging out, right? And these are all the tubers. Look at these nice white tubers that you could eat. So, I mean, this plant made a whole bunch of little small ones. Now, some of these are really cool to eat, you know, if they're nice size, but then these small ones are perfect for propagation. Basically, you put this back actually in the dirt, and it'll grow into a whole new plant next season. And that's how these guys spread. I mean, look down in the ground here. I barely even pulled any out, but you could see all these little guys just hanging out. And if I dig down in the ground more, I mean, there's even more of these guys. Like, these are so prolific, it's so crazy. Like this one plant provides so much food. And you know, this is a tuberous root vegetable. Now the cool thing about the sunchokes, as you guys will see in a little bit, is that these guys, they don't even need to be cooked. Like potatoes, you should be cooking them before you eat them. These guys, you just wash them off, and this one's not even that dirty. Wash them off, slice them into little chips. I like to dip them in some guacamole, some salsa, some kind of like nut-based salad dressing or dip, like orange juice blended with some macadamia nuts, for example, or some tomatoes and peppers blended with some cashews, a little bit of seasoning, and these guys are quite delicious. So look at this, we're just digging in here, and now we got all these sunchokes just from this little area right here. Let's go ahead and pull some more of this guy up. All right, look at that. I really like unearthing this, man. It makes me feel like a kid again when I'm like just digging in dirt. And look at all these guys right underneath here. That's like so cool. Oh, and we got some of the Chinese chives here. But yeah, like lots more of these guys. So if we just kind of like dig through the earth, look at this, as I dig in here, they're all underneath here, like so many of these guys. Here's more. And so if they're super small and tiny like this, I usually just, it's too small to ship or anything, I just throw them back, and those white guys will come back next year. Now the funny thing is I didn't necessarily plant the sunchokes in this location. Somehow they just started coming up here. I'm all right with that because it works, right? But next year, I don't know if I want them here specifically because I have a bed specifically designed for them and dedicated to them. So I might try to pull some of these out. But you know what? Once you have them somewhere, you will probably miss some of those small guys. And they just will end up coming back on their own, right? So plant them where you want them or keep them in a pot. Anyways, I'm going to dig through here and see how many more I could find. And we're going to come back at you. With some of the sunchokes actually I harvested 2 days ago. Alright, so as you guys can see, I harvested all my sunchokes, and when I harvest them, I like to put them in like this nursery flat that has like a nice grid on the bottom. You could also use like a produce crate, because they have small holes, like produce crates that like cactus fruits come in, or tomatillos come in from Mexico. They're plastic, I like to use that. And then basically I'll put them in here, and then I'll hose them off really good if I'm going to be eating them. That way all the water drains, and I'll do that in my garden so all the water stays in my garden instead of just like taking these inside to like wash them into the faucet, right? And that's if you're going to be eating them, right? Otherwise, once again, I said leave them under the ground until you're ready to harvest them. Even under the winter, if it's snowing, right? Put another stake placeholder in place, maybe mulch the ground pretty heavy, and you can just go out there in the winter and dig them up, because these guys will survive underground all winter long. And then they're going to sprout up the following spring when the weather gets nicer, right? So what I'm going to do next, actually, is we're going to show you guys, actually, if you do harvest your sunchokes in advance, how you could actually store them inside, like in a cool room, in a cellar, or in an unheated garage. You don't want to bring these like inside. You want to leave them somewhere cool, you know, in a pot. So I'll show you guys how I'm storing these until they get shipped out to you guys. So now I'm going to show you guys actually how I'm storing the sunchokes I harvested 2 days ago, because you guys just saw me dig these up. But what I have right here is just like a big tote from like Home Depot or Walmart or Costco. And what it is, if you look in here, this is all my homemade compost. And this is what it looks like. Now this compost is pretty fresh. It's still moist. It's not super dry. And what I've done was, I put a layer of these sunchokes in here. And then I just poured this fresh compost up on top to basically bury them, right? And this is how they'll best survive, because this basically simulates that they're still in the ground and actually they haven't been dug up yet. So let's take a look in here, right? So in here, if I just start digging, right? Check it out, it's like I'm excavating and I'm unearthing dinosaurs and other creatures inside here. Because they're basically just waiting in here for me to dig up. It's really cool. I could just dig up in here all day, and I got all these cool, funny shaped sunchokes. And so this is the best way to store your sunchokes. Basically, it simulates like they're still living in the ground. These are living creatures, really. And they're still living and breathing. They need to respirate. You know, don't just harvest them and put them in a plastic bag and then put them in your fridge. You know, a lot of places sell sunchokes, and it's quite unfortunate that many places sell sunchokes, you know, at the supermarket or whatever, or a specific specialty grocery stores, will get these guys and they'll just put them in the fridge. And that's the worst way, because it's so dry in the fridge, it dries them out. They get old and soft and mealy, and then they may no longer be viable, right? So, you know, these are grown specifically for me to eat. Now, as you guys see, I just harvested this, you know, the standard kind of like white variety of sunchoke, but I got some special ones that I want to show you guys that actually I grew on purpose to get them out to more people, because they actually are quite rare. As much as I like the white sunchokes, because they are quite delicious, quite good, really mild, even sweet flavor, high in prebiotic fibers that could help feed your probiotic beneficial bacteria in your gut, and it's been shown to help with blood sugar issues and immune system, all this kind of stuff. I want to have a more nutritious version, so let me go ahead and show you guys actually the red sunchokes that I have available for you guys. So over on this bin, and they basically, this bin is one of those oversized concrete mixing tubs. You know, another thing I'm using to store my sunchokes. Once again, I layered a layer of compost on the bottom, then basically put like layers of sunchokes, layers of compost, and then actually I even put some mulch in a plastic bag over the top so it doesn't get too dry and the sun doesn't hit it, right? But this would be better actually stored in a garage, in a cool place. You want to make sure the soil doesn't dry out too much. It stays a little bit moist but not sopping wet. But anyways, if we dig these guys down a little bit, let's see if I could find anything in here. I kind of made them kind of deep in here. Let's see. Oh, there's one. Here's one. They're kind of hiding. I can't even find them now. All right, here's one. So look at these guys. These guys are ultra rare, man. I rarely see these guys. And these are actually the red sunchokes. So here's the difference, you know, red sunchokes versus the white ones. These are the common ones you see, but these ones are red. They taste pretty much the same, but these ones, since because they're red, they have a more anthocyanins or plant pigments in there, which means they're gonna be higher antioxidant quality because of the skin. And I do encourage you guys to eat the skin and all in these guys once they're properly washed. So, you know, as it has been in previous years, what I do when I sell these guys is I don't just send you like a bag full of these guys. That'd be a very bad way to ship them, because, you know, these guys need to breathe and live in the soil, you know, as they came out of. So what I like to do is I ship these to you guys in soil, right, in some compost. So let me go ahead and show you guys how I will ship these to you guys, or actually how my girlfriend's gonna ship these to you guys, so you guys can grow your own very own sunchokes from these tubers. So how we ship these to you guys is actually we take a priority flat rate padded envelope and we carefully open it up. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and put in some compost in there. So we like line the bottom with a little bit of compost, flatten it out, and then we take a bunch of sunchokes and we make like one layer of sunchokes in here, as many as we could fit in. And then we take more compost, layer it on up. So we have like a basically compost layer, sunchoke layer, compost, and we like layer up more sunchokes in there, one layer. Then we layer up more compost. And then more sunchokes. So basically we do this until the bag is full. I think the bag weighs like maybe 4 pounds. I haven't done this in a while. And then the sunchokes inside will be approximately 2 pounds of sunchokes, plus or minus. We are not selling these by weight. It's being sold just by the full package, however many sunchokes we could fit in there. I have, I think this year I harvested mostly the standard white ones. So you're probably gonna get like, I'm gonna think like 60 to 70% white ones to 30 to 40% red ones in each package. Then we're just gonna go ahead and seal this up for you guys, and we're gonna ship it to you, and we're gonna tape it up good so it doesn't blow open on the post office and it's gonna get dirt everywhere. And so now the trick is, once you get this, what do you do with it? Because that's the most important thing. Don't just be like, John, I got busy and I left the sunchokes in the bag for 2-3 months. I mean, they may make it in the bag, but don't do it. The best way to do it is once you get this in the mail, you're going to just take some kind of pot, whether you got a 1 gallon pot or whether you got a 5 gallon pot. You're going to want to get your own compost, right? And it should be a little bit moist, not sopping wet, not, you know, super dry either, a little bit moist. And you're just going to put it, you know, you're going to line the bottom of that pot with a little bit of the compost, and you're going to basically empty out the contents of this into the pot. Now, if you're just doing 1 gallon, you could almost like pre-start these guys in 1 gallon. And how I do that is, you know, I fill this pot up probably 75% of the way full, just kind of like that. And then, you know, literally you could just do one of these guys per pot, because each one of these guys will turn into one plant and produce more tubers. So if you got a lot of pots, you could actually just make them ready for the season and just set them up like that and make sure it stays like, you know, moist but not sopping wet. You just want to simulate like how they would be out in nature. You don't want them too dry. I mean, in arid climates, it'll be a problem, but as long as you have your compost pretty moist and you put it in your garage over the winter where it's cool and all this stuff, it should be fine. You could put like, you know, 2 or 3 of them per 1 gallon pot, and basically you'll have a couple plants per pot. You could then just take this once they start popping out, and you could transplant the whole pot in. You could also open these guys up. Once they start popping out of the ground, you could separate them, or you could just put them all into like 1 5-gallon pot and let them sit there. And so once you could work the soil in the springtime after the frost has all passed, then you could actually get these guys planted out into the garden. Now, if you live somewhere like, you know, in a mild climate winter where it's no frost on the ground yet, hey, plant these guys as soon as you get the bag into the ground instead of putting them in the pot, right? This will save you guys work later. Just find a nice place you want to put them. You know, I'd probably bury them at least, 5 inches underneath the frost line, so like the ground doesn't freeze and these guys don't freeze. I don't know if these guys could freeze directly and still be alive, but if you put it a few inches underneath the soil, they'll be fine. And then of course, I would also want you guys to mulch on top to insulate the soil a little bit better. Of course, the safer way is just to keep them in pots until you're ready to plant them out for next season. I think the last thing I'd like to do is we're gonna go ahead and cut some of these guys up, and I'm gonna show you guys how I love to eat my sunchokes. All right, so now I'm sitting where I actually harvested those sunchokes. They're kind of like lying right here. Now I'm back, we got the sunchokes actually cut up. I got a standard red one and the white one. And we got some guacamole my beautiful girlfriend just made. It's a tomatillo guacamole, fresh avocado. And first I'm gonna go ahead and try just the standard white one that I actually grew right here. And so we basically cut them into chips, just dip them in the guacamole. Mmm, nice and crunchy. Listen to that crunch. These are like at least 100 times better than fried potato chips. Mmm, fresh from the garden. Quite good. Now I'm gonna try one of those red ones here. These are actually really sweet, really delicious. I don't think I'll be able to stop eating these guys. All right, red one. Mmm. I mean, pretty similar flavor on the red or the white one. Just the outside color's different. This is super delicious. Mmm. Anyways, you guys want to get your very own sunchokes that I grew in my garden with compost and rock dust, no sprays, all organic. Click the link down below. We'll get those shipped out to you as soon as we can. Let's see here. One price includes a shipping. And then order some other seeds if you need it. At the same time, free shipping as well. The sunchokes are my favorite tuberous root vegetable to grow because they are so prolific. They produce so much. And then I want to mention, while I did show using compost to put them in, you don't have to use compost. You could just use dirt out of your yard. You could use potting soil. You know, any kind of bag soil product you guys have laying around. I happen to have some homemade compost that actually was the right moisture level, easy to grab over on that side of the yard, so that's what I use to store them in. But yeah, they're not too picky. I wouldn't use sand or anything like that. That's going to drain out too fast. You need to have some organic matter in there so that they could breathe. I wouldn't use mud either, of course. So that's pretty much it. When you get them, make sure you plant them out, deal with them as soon as possible, get them out of that envelope so that they can breathe. And you could be growing these for many years to come. And make sure you dedicate a space for them, because you could be cursing me out. Man, I bought those sunchokes and now they're taking over. But hey, you're going to have lots of food to eat during the entire winter season because of these sunchokes in many years to come. Hey, and if you guys bought sunchokes from me in the past, hey, post down below your comments, how they grew for you, how you did, and how you love them and enjoy them. Because that's pretty much the end of this episode. The sun's going down. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and finish up some of this stuff. If you like this video, hey, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. That'll encourage me to do more videos like this. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on any of my new and upcoming episodes that are coming out every 3 to 4 days. You never know where I'll show up or what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel. Also, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, over 1,300 episodes on this YouTube channel at this time. Teach you guys all aspects on how you guys can grow your food at home. With that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. Until then, remember, keep on growing.